In last class, we have discussed about long transmission line. Today, we shall discuss about the problems. Okay, one problem that is a transmission line, a three-phase transmission line, 200 kilometer long, has the following constants. They have given the resistance per phase per kilometer, and also reactance per phase per kilometer, and they have given shunt admittance per phase per kilometer. Okay, they have given the values, and we need to calculate the sending end voltage and current while the line is delivering a load of 20 megawatt at 0.8 power factor lagging. The receiving end voltage is kept constant at 110 kV. They have given per phase per kilometers, so they have given the 200 kilometer. Okay, if you observe this question, they have given a transmission line 200 kilometer. Just multiply, okay, 0.16 into 200, you'll get 32 ohm, and 0.25 into 200, and that is you multiply with the kilometer what they have given in the question, so you'll get the, in terms of ohm, that is 32 ohm, that is resistance, and XL, and next Y value you'll get. Okay, next is EV is impedance per phase, that is Z is equal to R plus jXL. R value we know and XL value we know. Just to substitute and get in the form of polar, okay, you'll get in the calcified complex equations. If you go with the complex equations, you can convert the complex equation into a polar form. Vs, okay, Vs they have asked to find out. Vs is equal to what? Vr cos h, that is square root of y into z, plus Ir square root of z by y, sin h square root of z into y. First, before substituting, we don't know the value of square root of y into z and also square root of z by y. Okay, we need to calculate that one first. So z by y, and also for Is, what we need here, you see the equation for Is, we want square root of y into z. Okay, similar. Okay, this is reverse y by z. And here cos h square root of yz means 1 plus zy divided by 2 plus z square y square divided by 24. So we need to find out zy and also z square y square, and also we need to find out y and square root of y into z and square root of z by y and also y by z. Okay, these parameters we need to find out. First, we shall find out square root of z into y. Z value is this one, okay, z value, and y value is this one. So multiply, what you'll get, if you multiply 59.4 into 0.0003, you'll get 0.0178. okay, but here angle at angle 58, at angle 90, we cannot multiply. Okay, so at angle A, at angle B, if it is there, what we can take at angle A plus B. So 58 plus 90, you'll get 148. This is nothing but z into y value. Okay, and this is nothing but z into y value. So square root of z into y is equal to what we can write here. This is the, here one, there is a formula. If this is the condition, square root of r at angle theta, then we can write that as r to the power of 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 into theta. If you observe this note, square root of r at angle theta. Okay, this is r and this is angle, this is theta. Okay, so r to the power of 1 by 2, 0.0178 to the power of 1 by 2. And here 148 divided by 2, if you do, you'll get 74. This is the value of square root of z into y. Okay, and next z square y square. Okay, 0.1, that is z square y square means we know the value of zy. Okay, 0.0178 at angle 148. So 0.0178 at angle 148 into 0.0178 at angle 148, that is two times. Okay, z into y, z square y square. So what you'll get if you multiply 0.00032 at angle, this you add 148 148, you'll get 296. Okay, that is the value of z square y square. Next, square root of z by y. So here square root of z value is this one and y value is this one. So here 58 minus 90, what you'll get? 16. Okay. So next, is a 0.003 at angle 90 divided by 59.4 at angle 58. Okay. So if you do that. You'll get 32. Okay, here the angle when you do it is square root. Okay, you'll get the value 58 minus 90, 32. But here it is a square root. So divided by 32 divided by 2, what you'll get? 16. Okay, that is what we have written here because it is in the square root. So 59.4 divided by 0.0003, you'll get 445, and that is after square root value. Okay, next 58 minus 90, if you do minus 32, that because the square root divided by 2, so you'll get minus 16. Okay, similarly you need to calculate for square root of y by z. Now cos h square root of y into z means 1 plus zy divided by 2 plus z square y square divided by 24. We know the all the parameter values, so substitute and get, you'll get the value 0.992 at angle 0.26. okay, if you got in the complex form, you convert into the polar form. Next, sin h square root of y into z is equal to square root of y into z plus yz to the power of 3 by 2 divided by 6. Okay, substitute this square root of yz value and yz to the power of 3 by 2. Okay, yz to the power of 3 by 2 divided by 6. Here, angle to the power of a means a into theta. So a into theta means 3 by 2 into 142, you'll get 222. Okay. So next, you'll get the equation in terms of complex form, and you calculate in the polar form 0.1325 at angle 74.10. You'll get, okay. First, you convert this in polar complex form and add the all the parameters, add the real parts and complex part. Okay. So you'll get 0.0363 plus 0.1275 j. Okay, this you convert in the polar form, you'll get 0.1325 at angle 74.10. okay, that is the sin h square root of y into z value. You need to calculate. Okay, now I am explaining you step by step practice so that you'll get the all the values and you'll come to know. VR is equal to 110, they have given 110 kilo voltage, 110 kilo voltage divided by square root of V, you'll get 63.508 kilo voltage VR. IR is equal to what? P value, they have given 20 megawatt, and VR value, and this is the cos phi R value. Okay, so you'll get 131 amps. Next, VS is equal to what? VR, that is VR and cos h square root of y into z plus IR square root of z by y and also into sin h square root of z into y. Okay, VS equation, they have substituted all the parameters. So you first step by step, if it is in the polar form, you convert into complex form, then you calculate. Okay, after getting the final equation, that you convert into a polar form. 67,429.17 at angle 5.82. This is the VS sending end voltage. And next, sending end line to line voltage means just multiply into square root of 3. You'll get, that is a 11 is 11.67. Is there any problem? Okay, we get after multiplying, that is you'll get 116,790.7484, or we can say that is 116,790.7484. Okay, is equal to vr square root of y by z sin h square root of y into z plus ir cos h square root of y into z. We already know the these values, okay. Just substitute cos h value, cos h square root of y by z, y into z, we know the value, and sin h square root of y into z, we know the value. So just substitute, you'll get 131.3 at angle 8.50. Okay, this is the problem regarding the long transmission line. Next, we shall discuss with the determination of generalized constants for transmission line for long lines, rigorous method. Okay. We know that Vs is equal to, okay, Vs is equal to what? A into Vr plus B into Ir. The Is equal to C into Vr plus D into Ir. So Vs is equal to, we know the equation, that is Vr cos h square root of y into z plus Ir square root of z by y sin h square root of y into z. Is equal to, we know the equations, okay, in long transmission line. Just to take out the long transmission line equation Vs and Is, okay. Next, compare the equations 3 and 4 with those of equation 1 and 4. If you observe the equations Vr equation and Ir equation, it is directly mentioned. It is in the terms of Vr and Ir, so that we can say that A bar and D bar is equal to cos h square root of y into z. B bar is equal to what you'll get? B bar is this one, okay. C value is this one, square root of y by z sin h square root of y into z. And D value is cos h square root of y into z. If you see this here, A bar and D bar will be same, okay. So here, A bar D bar minus B bar C bar, if you calculate cos square h square root of y into z minus here z by y, y by z, this will be get cancelled, okay. This will be get cancelled. So sin h square square root of y into z, you'll get 1, okay. This value is 1. Cos h square minus sin h square is, value is 1. Next, the problem on this long transmission line, two transmission lines having a generalized circuit constants A1, B1, C1, D1 and A2, B2, C2, D2 are connected in a series and also parallel. Derive expression for overall ABCD constants of the resulting network. This derivation they have asked many times, okay, concentrate on this derivation. Network in series, okay, network in series A1, B1, C1, D1, okay, A2, B2, C2, D2. Input is Vs and output is Vr. Here input current is Is and the output current is Ir, and in middle I, okay. For second circuit, input current is I and the input voltage is V, okay. Now we shall write the equations of Vs is equal to what we can write? A1 into V, that is A1 into V plus B1 into I, okay. A1 into V plus B1 into I. Next, V is equal to, okay, what is the V? V is equal to A2 into Vr plus B2 into Ir. Next, the third equation, what we can write? Is is equal to similar, C1 into V plus D1 into I. Okay, next, again for I is equal to C2 into Vr plus D2 into Ir. Okay, these are the four equations. If you observe here, equation 2 and 4, okay. Equation 2 and 4 is we can substitute in the equation 1 and 3 because here v and I value we know. So we can substitute in the equation 1 and 3. Okay. So substitute equation 2 and 4 in equation 1 and 3, we get that Vs is equal to A1, so substitute V value, plus B1, substitute I value. Just multiply. After multiplying, what you'll get here? Vr, here Vr. So take out Vr common, A1 plus A1 into A2 plus B1 into C2, whole bracket Vr, plus again here Ir, Ir. So take out Ir common, what you'll get? A1 into B2 plus B1 into D2. Okay, now we got the equation Vs in terms of Vr and Ir. That too in terms of A1 and A2, B1 and B2, like that. Okay, Is is equal to C1 into V plus D1 into I. We know the value of V and I. Substitute, after substituting the value, what you'll get? You'll get in terms of Vr and Ir. Just take out common. Okay, first take out common Vr. So that you'll get this value, A2 C1 plus C2 D1. Next take out Ir common, so that you'll get C1 B2 plus D1 D2. This is the equation 6. Okay. So Vs is equal to A into Vr plus B into Ir. Is is equal to C into Vr plus D into Ir. From these equations, when you compare with the what we got, the 5 and 6 equation, then we can write A is equal to what? We can write A1 into A2 plus B1 into C2. B is equal to A1 into B2 plus B1 into D2. Okay, this is the C value and this is the D value. And this is a A value and this is a B value. Okay, from equation 5 and 6, when you compare with the equation 7 and 8, you'll get the A, B, C, D values. Okay. Next, network in parallel. The standard equation 7 and 8, you'll get the A, B, C, D values. Next, networks in parallel. Similarly, we write the equation here, Vs is equal to, by seeing the circuit, we can write that A1 into Vr plus B1 into Ir1. Okay. This is a here two current you'll get Ir1 and Ir2. Okay. So Vs is equal to A1 into Vr plus B1 into Ir1. For next, Vs is equal to A2 into Vr plus here Vr you'll get. Okay. A2 into Vr plus B2 into Ir2. Okay. This second circuit. Is1 is equal to C1 into Vr plus D1 into Ir1. Is2 is equal to C2 into Vr plus D2 into Ir2. Now equation, that is 1 and 2, equate. Okay, if you equate the two equations 1 and 2, what you'll get? Vr is, you can see Vr. So Vr, if you take out common, A1 minus A2, that is equal to B2 into Ir2 minus B1 into Ir1. Ir is equal to what? We can write Ir1 plus Ir2. From this, what we can write? Ir2 is equal to Ir minus Ir1. Okay, so if you take out, instead of writing Ir2, they have substituted Ir minus Ir1. After solving the equation, what you'll get? Ir1 is equal to B2 into Ir minus Vr into A1 minus A2 divided by B1 plus B2. Okay. Next, similarly, Vs is equal to A1 into Vr plus B1 into Ir1. Now we know the value of Ir1. Substitute, what you'll get? Here, take out Vr common because here also Vr and here also Vr. So if you take out Vr common, A1 minus B1 into A1 minus A2 divided by B1 plus B2. This they have taken LCM. After solving LCM, you'll get A1 into B2 plus B1 into A2 divided by B1 plus B2 into Vr plus B1 into B2 divided by B1 plus B2 into Ir. Now it is in the terms of Vr and Ir. So this is the value of A and this is the value of B. Next, Is1 plus Is2 is equal to, that is equation 3 and 4. Okay, Is1 plus Is2 is equal to C1 plus C2 into Vr. If you observe here, the equations what we have written in the starting, Is1 plus Is2. Okay, So IS1 plus IS2 means here also we are, here also we are. So C1 plus C2 into VR. C1 plus C2 into VR plus D1 into IR1 plus D2 into IR2. We know the value of IR2, that is IR minus IR1. Okay. So after solving, what you'll get here? Here they have substituted the IR1 value. Okay. After substituting, final expression it should be in terms of VR and IR. Okay. So C1 plus C2 into VR plus D2 into IR plus D1 minus D2, they have substituted the IR1 value. Okay. Now take out the common, that is VR. What you'll get after taking the common, you'll get this one value, and after taking the IR common, you'll get this value. Okay. So if you want, you should solve step by step by solving the LCM. Okay. You can take the LCM. What you'll get here, D2 B2 get cancelled. So you'll left with this. Okay. This is the final expression in terms of VR and IR. This we can say that is a, it is a IS equation. So this is a C value and this is a D value. Okay. This is a D value. This is D and this is C. Okay. From network in parallel, we have found out A value, B value, and also C and D value. Okay. Next is a Ferranti effect. When a long line is operating under no load or a light load condition, the receiving end voltage is greater than the sending end voltage. This is known as Ferranti effect. You have already came to know about this Ferranti effect. Okay. Because in many times, when a long line is operating under no load, okay, if the long line is operating under no load or a light load condition, the receiving end voltage will be greater than the sending end voltage. This is known as a Ferranti effect. A simple explanation on Ferranti effect can be given by approximately, that is a distributed parameters of the line by lumped impedance, that is a capacitive reactance of the line is quite large as compared to the inductive reactance. Under no load or a light loaded condition, the line current is half leading power factor. The phasor diagram you can observe here. They are saying that the charging current produces a drop in the reactance of the line, which is in phase opposition to the receiving end voltage, and hence the sending end voltage becomes smaller than the receiving end voltage. Okay. What they are saying is sending end voltage will be small than the receiving end voltage. Okay, receiving end voltage will become more here. It may be due to what they are saying, the reason it may be under no load or light load conditions. Okay. We can say by another example, that is another way of explaining, that is Ferranti effect is based on the net reactive power flow on the line. It is known that if the reactive power generated at a point is more than the reactive power observed, what they are saying is reactive power generation is more than the reactive power observed. If generation is a 10 watt, for example 10 watt reactive power, then if it is observed 15, if absorption is 15, then what happens? Okay, so they are saying that it is known that if the reactive power generated at a point is more than the reactive power observed, if the inductive loads, it will observe more reactive power, the voltage at the point becomes higher than the normal value and vice versa. The surge impedance loading will give a definite meaning to the terms lightly loaded or fully loaded lines. If the loading is less than the surge impedance loading, the reactive power generated is more than the observed. Therefore, the receiving end voltage is greater than the sending end voltage. What they are saying, that receiving end voltage will be greater when you compare with the sending end voltage. This explains therefore the phenomena due to Ferranti effect. In fourth modules, we shall discuss about the corona topic. Vs is equal to, here this is the equation for Ferranti effect. Vs is equal to Vr plus resistive drop plus reactive drop. That is, Vs is equal to Vr plus Ic into R plus jIc into X. If you take out Ic common, R plus jX, that is Ic is equal to, we can write in terms of j omega C into Vr, R plus j omega XL. So Vs is equal to Vr minus omega square CL Vr plus j omega CR Vr. Okay, this is a Ferranti effect. We can explain in two terms. In terms of that is the reactive power generated at a point is more than reactive power observed. That is, in terms of, we can explain in terms of power generation, and also we can explain in terms of current. That is, if you compare the capacitive reactance of a line is quite large as compared to the inductive reactance. Okay, under no load or light load conditions, the line current is of leading power factor. So by representation under no load conditions, by using phasor diagram, we can explain, okay, Ferranti effect. The charging current will produce a drop in the reactance of the line, which will which is in phase opposition to the receiving end voltage, and the sending, and that's why sending end voltage will become a smaller than the receiving end voltage. By using a two methods, we can explain the Ferranti effect. In next class, we shall discuss with the fourth module, corona, and also underground cables.